word obelisk literally means Baal's shaft or Baal's organ of reproduction. It's almost always placed in the center of a circle, the solar wheel, which represents the female genitalia and the physical sexual act. We can see in the Bible, in Hebrew, the word for pillar or idol is kaman, and kaman literally means sun idol or sun pillar. You can see in Isaiah 27:9, it's used this way. By this, therefore, shall the iniquity of Jacob be purged, and this is all the fruit to take away his sin, when he marketh all the stones of the altar as chalk stones that are beaten in sunder, the groves and the images shall not stand up. That word images there is kaman, and that kaman is talking about an obelisk. Here is some pictures. We're going to roll through the entire world here. We're going to circle the globe and show you pictures throughout the entire world of these obelisks in their raw format. And on some of these, as the one that you can see here in Turkey, you can see that the ancient hieroglyphic and their language and pictures are actually still on these obelisks. Cleopatra's needle is not just a neat little emblem. This was erected as a commemoration to the sun god there in London. This is the oldest obelisk in Scotland. This is the oldest obelisk in Switzerland. How about Mecca? How about Luxor, Egypt, near the Nile River? There is an Egyptian obelisk. This is one of the most famous obelisks in the entire world. It's in Buenos Aires, Argentina. It's dedicated to the sun god Ra. Here's one in Amsterdam. Here's one in Ethiopia, Mongolia. How about the Washington Monument? This is the same exact structure that they built in ancient Egypt for the sun gods, as we've demonstrated thoroughly. Let me ask you a question. Where do we find this main symbol of the sun god today? Where do we find this main symbol of the obelisk? Would it shock you to discover that we find it in our churches? That's right. That's where the sun god obelisk ended up. It ends up in our churches all around the world. We call them steeples. They're called obelisk in ancient Egypt. If Pharaoh or an ancient Egyptian was alive today, they would walk down the street and they would feel comfortable coming to most of the churches that we have today, because they would say, wow, that is my religion. That's something that I can connect to. That is sun god worship. And we see throughout all around the world, here's one that has two pillars that are built into this particular church. Ladies and gentlemen, the obelisk, the sun god worship, there shouldn't be one single symbol anywhere of ancient paganism or Egyptian sun god worship that is found inside of our religious societies today in Christianity.